Welcome! Today on Power Drift, we have the brand new 2021 TVS Apache RTR 200 4V BS6 ABS. It's a long name, kindly adjust. I also didn't appear in the frame from here or here, I came from the bottom, kindly adjust. We're so used to making compromises in our daily lives today that the phrase kindly adjust doesn't really bother us anymore. But the surprise is that that's what the TVS Apache is trying to tell you to do. It's telling you to kindly adjust. Because what TVS is built into this new motorcycle is a lot of adjustability, which means that this motorcycle adapts to you a lot more than usual, rather than you having to adapt to what the motorcycle is. But what does that mean? Let's start at the basics, and for that you have to subscribe to Power Drift, hit the bell notification icon so that we can send India's best automotive content straight to you. The story of adjustability on the RTR begins with the levers, which are now adjustable, clutch and brake, both, and that means that you can determine the distance between the bar and the lever, so whether your fingers are long or short, you'll have a comfortable motorcycle. This seems like a feature you'll use only once. It does seem like a feature that's almost frivolous, but the fact of the matter is, when controls fall to hand, then in a panic situation, you don't have to figure out where the levers are, and it does save you a little bit of time. The caveat is some of us get lazy, and as our brakes get older, we start using the span adjuster as a way to keep using the same thing, whereas we should really be going to service. But that's only a small change. The big change is in the engine, where there is no mechanical change, although this motorcycle is 1 kilo lighter, but TVS has been able to extract more power from this motorcycle. So from the last one, the 2020 to the 2021, you get 1 PS more and a little bit more torque. But TVS has gone one step forward, and they've given this riding modes. But for that, I'm going to throw a few terms at you which will sound repetitive, but stay with me here. The engine has two modes, there's sport and urban. In sport mode, it's a crisp engine with a very, very direct power delivery, and it makes all the 21 PS. But when you switch to urban mode, you trade in about 3.5 PS and a little bit of torque, and what you get is a more mellow, a calmer, more refined engine, and TVS says you might even get 5 to 8% more fuel economy in that mode. Now you might ask, does a 21 bhp motorcycle really need engine riding modes? And my answer is, people like us who ride a lot of motorcycles, we may not notice it so much, but I can imagine that if you're a new rider trying to get used to 125 kilometers an hour motorcycle, they could be useful at least for a while until you settle into the motorcycle, and then sport becomes your new normal. On the other hand, TVS actually expects a lot of customers to use urban mode quite a bit, rain mode during rain, and we'll talk about that, and sport mode when they're out on the highway, and performance is really key. And I think that makes sense. But that's not all they've done. They've also got modes for ABS, and you've got three modes again, and they're called, wait for it, sport, urban, and wet. In sport mode, the ABS is at its least intrusive. You can really, really lean on the brakes, and these are really good tires, so it will be difficult to activate ABS in conditions like this, dry. The middle setting is obviously the middle setting, and at the bottom is rain, which is a very, very aggressive ABS mode, so that if there's any wetness on the road and your tires start to lock up, the ABS will immediately be active. Now, I can imagine that two engine modes and three ABS modes might get very confusing for a rider to set up, so what you get is a mode switch that creates the riding modes, which is a combination of these settings. So when you select sport mode, you get full power, that's the sport engine mode and the least aggressive ABS setting. When you switch to urban riding mode, you get the urban engine setting, that's 3.5 bhp less, and the middle setting for ABS. And when you switch to rain, you get the same mellow engine in urban mode, but the ABS switches to the rain setting, and that's how they've organized it. And when you're out riding, I didn't get to try the ABS, but the engine modes certainly make a difference. There is difference in acceleration between urban engine settings and sport settings. Sport is very, very crisp, just like we remember the RTR being, whereas urban mode is a lot calmer, a lot sweeter. In fact, a lot more like the RTR 160 than the 200 in the way it feels and the way it delivers power. It's actually rather enjoyable, although eventually I got bored and went right back to the sport setting. So, small step, adjustable levers, bigger step, engine riding modes, but the biggest step, I think, is the fact that the front suspension, these are Showa forks, are now preload adjustable. Now, most people think that preload is a way to make the suspension stiffer or softer, and that's technically not accurate. What preload determines is how high the motorcycle sits on its suspension. In effect, it's a ride height control. If you take this RTR and remove the weight of the engine and the frame, you'd realize that the suspension would extend a little bit. It's currently slightly compressed. But when I sit down on it and add my 85 odd kilos in gear to the motorcycle, it sits down further on the suspension. The problem is all suspension has three zones. There is a middle zone, which we call the sweet spot, which is where it does its best work. And there are two zones on the side where it's not so optimal. What TVS has done is it tunes their motorcycles for riders between 65 and 80 kilos. So if you fall in that weight range, this is what the preload setting you'll get, and it'll work for you most of the time. But if you're above 80 kilos, or you're carrying a pillion with you, or luggage, or out touring, or something like that, or you're genetically blessed and you're a 41 kilo guy like a MotoGP rider, these suspension settings aren't the best for you, although they still continue to work quite a bit. So if you were to mess with your preload at that point, you'd go harder preload if you were heavier, lighter preload if you were lighter, you would immediately get a motorcycle that remains in the suspension sweet spot for more of your riding time, making it a sweeter motorcycle to ride, making it a more responsive motorcycle overall. That's why I would say that the big bike guys immediately go for exhaust. If they were to set up their suspension first, they'd get a bigger performance upgrade from that. And I'm so happy to see that TVS has been able to do adjustable suspension on a motorcycle from this segment. This is good work, and I wish other manufacturers would do this as well. And I hope that you guys will use this to your advantage as well. What you need to do is what we call set sag. Look it up on the internet. There are lots of videos. You need a friend to do it, and it's absolutely crucial that you do it, because the motorcycle experience changes quite a bit when your sag is set right. Your preload is in the right place. But the kicker for me is that TVS has managed to do all of this, including this really nice blue color, in just 1,000 rupees more than the outgoing dual channel 200. How they've crammed so much into the motorcycle at that smaller cost, difficult to figure out. Kindly adjust. But the fact of the matter is that makes the RTR 200 already one of our favorite motorcycles in the class, and even more value for money motorcycle. So that brings us to the question of, is this still the best in class, or is the Honda Hornet going to upset this apple cart? Well, as we record this, we still don't have access to a test bike from Honda, and therefore I'm going to have to ask you to kindly adjust. And that leaves us with the question of what happens to the single channel ABS version of the 200 4V, which is of course currently on sale. I believe that this suspension with more power and the riding modes, etc., will make its way to that motorcycle. Although we don't know when, I'm not convinced that that motorcycle will have the adjustable suspension or not. When will this happen? Well, TVS hasn't told us. Kindly adjust. And that's the story of the RTR 200. But before I go, let me remind you, subscribe to Power Drift and hit the bell notification icon, because this video also has a giveaway. All you have to do is subscribe to Power Drift on YouTube, follow us on Instagram, we are at Power Drift, and answer this simple question: how many riding modes does the TVS Apache RTR 200 4V ABS BS6 have? Do these things correctly, leave us a comment, and you could win one of five Cruise Tools Outbacker Multi-Tools. Cruise Tools makes fantastic tools, and they're represented in India by Big Bad Bikes. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please leave us a comment. Please share this with your friends. If you didn't like the video, kindly adjust.